All right, folks, God bless you guys, and welcome to This Is It, 4321. Before the fire. Guys, the entire Israeli conflict is so interesting to just look at and analyze. You know, if you look at it and you analyze it and you realize that the Israeli airspace is one of the most guarded and defended spaces in the world. And to think that a bunch of guys on paragliders at different locations just happened to all make it through and achieve these terroristic targets, it's kind of difficult to just really believe that. It looks like a setup. I deal with a lot of people that try and set things up. They say the cover-up is worse than the crime. Anyway, what's interesting is if you analyze the entire Israeli thing that's going on right now, President Biden said, oh, he's all behind Israel. That's not true. Everybody knows that Obama is running Biden. That's a common understanding throughout the geopolitical world, and the people in Washington and the pundits, they say it out loud. No, I'm sorry, say it out loud now. They say that quiet part out loud. They're just like, oh no. Jean-Pierre, I forget how to say her name sometime. The White House press secretary, she inadvertently said President Obama. So did Jean Psaki, I think is her name. The other White House press secretary accidentally said she loved working for President Obama. So Maria Bartiromo said everybody knows that Obama's calling the shots. So isn't it fascinating? $87 billion of equipment was left over there under the Biden administration, who is taking orders from everybody is saying Obama. That's what the pundits are saying. So, and it's pretty obvious. But then you think about it and you look at the overall picture and you look at the whole idea that there's going to be this Islamic world jihad. It's really fascinating when you start doing the math. Now, let me show you something that I find fascinating, because if it's not really this invasion as it really looks, it's just too sketchy. It looks like a false flag setup. Now, there were false flag setups before other false flags happened, like 9/11. Now, remember, 9/11 in the Bible is, quote, they had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name is Abaddon, in Greek tongue has a name Apollyon. Who has a king over them? The locust from the pit. Now, it's a two-party system. There's a good you and there's a bad you. Until you get converted, you are subject to that system. That's why the Bible says in James chapter 4, cleanse your hearts, you double-minded, because you're of two minds. You're good and evil. So let me show you something fascinating that's going on, because I want to compare a little bit 9/11, where the bombings of the Twin Towers and the Pentagon, they were printed on your money way before the bombings ever happened. So it had to be a false flag. Isn't it fascinating that there's no government entity that ever came out with the absolute proof that the bombings are printed on your money? I went and gave it to the FBI many years ago. I think 2014 is when I did. It's when I had my meeting. Let me show you something. Then we're going to move into some fascinating data. Tonight, I told you guys I was going to do a data video. Yesterday, I kind of just wanted to vent and get some stuff out there and get the scriptures out there that prove that Jesus's ministry, as mentioned in Isaiah, as mentioned in Luke chapter 4, was to make one new man from the two and to set the captives free by redoubling your eyes. I mean, it doesn't get any more obvious than that, guys. If you have one eye that's to heaven, one eye that's to the pit, that the eye that's to the pit is printed on your dollar bill as the all-seeing eye of the pyramid. So the one that we were trying to find or discover or turn back to is up. That's why the Bible says, to get made whole again, you redouble your eyes up. Watch, I'll show you. Right, let me show you that first, and then we'll move on. Let's go to the scriptures first. Okay, so in Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Okay, tonight I'm just going to take it nice and slow. Nice and slow and easy. Just dial it down a little bit with all the excitement that's going on because of the crazy stuff in California. And I have these phony people trying to break through on my phones and do all kinds of weird stuff. We're just documenting it, putting it up on the visor, watching the people that are trying to cover it up make it even worse. But anyway, that continues. But let me show you this. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance. Now, I want to show you deliverance. The word deliverance means pardon, deliverance, forgiveness. Deliverance to the captives, a prisoner of war, those that are carried away captive. It says to capture, to be taken. Isn't that kind of what a kidnapping is? You're captured and taken. I find it fascinating that the thing out in California with Richard, how he was taken captive and he was able to escape his captor and his bands were loosened and he was able to get away and we were able to bring him in by putting out an all points bulletin out on YouTube. And someone who was willing to step up and put themselves at risk went and brought him in and put him in a place of safety. He's got everything he needs right now. It's fascinating. Okay, here we go. Deliverance to the captives and the recovery of sight to the blind. Now, before I click on recovery of sight to the blind, I want you to look my shirt, Ephesians 2, right here. It says, his purpose was to make one new man from the two. And the word spirit is a superhuman angel demon. You'll see the word demon is upside down in pink. And then it says, or divine God, Christ, Spirit, the Holy Spirit. Because it's been proven now, you have a superhuman angel demon running you until you get converted. Then when you get converted, your eyes become single. So let me show you that. So the recovery of sight to the blind. Here you go. Ready? Restoration of sight. Ready? To look up and to receive sight. See it right there? So right here, I'm going to do this big circle on a blepo. The recovery of sight to the blind. On a blepo. It doesn't get more obvious than that. That's it. So, to look up, because we got inverted in the system, and when you let Jesus rule in the midst of you instead of Satan, you get converted, and both eyes go up. When Satan is sitting in the center of you and you haven't been converted, you still have an eye that goes to the pit. You're still controllable by that other source. Cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. Good and evil, you see? So it's absolute perfection in understanding the Bible. Okay, now let's talk about the twin towers because it's a twin system. So the twin towers, if Satan's running the show here and he wants to do a false flag and he destroys the twin towers and then in its place, the one world freedom tower replaces it, that means the two have become one in a fleshly sense. And that's the new temple for Satan to occupy. So the spirit of Satan will occupy that new host body temple. Okay, now let me just show you a couple images and let's talk about imagery. So here's that data I was talking about. We have this twins folder that just shows you how obvious things are. But let's go over here and let's look at a couple images and let's just talk about whether or not this is arguable or not. Okay, so here's the Arch of Washington and it's a commemorative arch and it's based on the Arch of Titus. They built the Arch of Titus to represent the fall of Jerusalem during the time of Titus when he destroyed the second temple on 9/11. He destroyed it on the 9th of Av, 9/11 as well. Nebuchadnezzar destroyed the first temple on the 9th of Av, 9/11. I mean, what are the odds? Do you know? It's like, wait a minute. So Nebuchadnezzar rolls in and destroys the temple in Jerusalem on the 9th of Av, the 11th month, 9/11. Then Titus rolls in during the time of the Romans, and he destroys the temple when Jesus said, "Do you not see all these things?" He didn't say buildings. His disciples said buildings. Jesus said, "Do you see all these things? Verily, I say unto you, there will not be one stone left on top of another that shall not be thrown down." The word things is him, her, they, them, these, her, this man, this woman. It's a bunch of personal pronouns. What's going on in the world right now? Gender confusion, personal pronouns. People want to be called him, her, they, them, whatever. It's very strange. Jesus said the time will come. Well, the temple represents your body. Isn't that fascinating? So now, let me show you the Twin Towers printed on the US currency. There is the $20 bill that shows the Twin Towers burning, and here's the Arch of Washington with the Twin Towers. Now, does anyone believe that that's not actually an image of the Twin Towers? Because I've taken those images and put them right alongside the building burning itself, and we can match them up very easily. So I'm gonna go like this, and I'm gonna show you the Twin Towers right here. There's the Twin Towers. Here's the Twin Tower bombing. I want you to look at the points of explosion. Look right here. Now look right here. Now look up here. Look up here. So here's one explosion. Look right here on the $20 bill. Perfect. Now look up. Look right there. Okay, so now that is a phenomenal likeness, agreed, of the Twin Towers on your $20 bill. Now, what makes it even crazier is on the backside of that $20 bill, the same exact bill has the Pentagon bombing that was bombed on the very same day. But the people that allegedly bombed these buildings, there's too much nonsense that kind of like the weird stuff I'm dealing with right now. No, too much nonsense. When there's too much nonsense, you know it's not true and people are involved. Now, let me show you. Okay, we're going to come back to this image in just a minute because I want to show you the federal building bombing as well, but I want to show you the backside of the $20 bill that's got the Twin Towers. Now, look at that. Here's the backside of the same building. You see the Pentagon, this white rectangular building with the three rows of square windows right here? And look, here's the explosion. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to scrunch it down a little bit. You can see the rectangular building, but now let's just do a comparative analysis of the building itself and the Pentagon. Now look right there. So the Pentagon and then the US currency. I mean, do you see a perfect I mean, yeah. One laid on top of the other. I mean, is that Do you see it? Is it perfect? So I'm asking you now, yes or no? Was the Twin Tower bombing a false flag? Yes or no? Well, sure, they enacted the Patriot Act and they came up with other legislation that basically looked like a good idea because of the bombings, to be able to and give certain powers to the government. But then those powers could be abused later under a different regime, I guess would be a good word. So anyway, so now we have look at the imagery we have here. So here's the other layers of ink that are on that bill. So look at that. Is that a bombing of the Pentagon? It's simply a yes or no answer. So to me, obviously, it's a no-brainer. Of course, that's a Pentagon bombing. Well, on the front side of the bill, of the other side is the Twin Towers and the Pentagon on one bill, and it was made in 96. That doesn't seem possible. Okay. So, and like I said, the reason I went to the FBI is because the Lord told me to go show him, because the Lord allowed me to prophesy in 2007 before Obama became president. And the words that came out of my mouth were, "Thus saith the Lord of hosts, behold, the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind." Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. Okay, those words that I just spoke were part of a prophetic utterance, and that ended up manifesting those words, out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. That's a nuclear attack, okay? So those words showed up on the new $100 bill that came out, I believe, and it was 2014. And then the words, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, manifested on the $10 bill. So if we're looking at different U.S. currency notes right now, like the old $20 bill or the $20 bill that's got the Twin Tower bombing and the Pentagon bombing on it, well, that's crazy. Well, then I went and looked at the old $20 bill that I grew up with. It was very different. And on that $20 bill was the federal building bombing. So now we know it's all a bunch of smoke and mirrors. Oh, look over here. So there's some force that's doing it. And it was the biggest mind racker in the world. I was like, how is this even possible? Because it's a spiritual thing. There's a spirit that works in the hearts of the children of disobedience that accomplishes those things. So there is the Pentagon bombing, and it's on your $20 bill. So you're looking right at it. So here's the Pentagon. There it is on the back. There's the Twin Towers. There's the actual Twin Towers. And now I want to go and show you the other $20 bill. So I'm going to establish a record right now. And then I want you to look right here at the, oops, don't know what happened there. I want you to look right here at this $20 bill right here. See that $20 bill? Right here. $20 bill, right? There's one here. And here's the federal building bombing. I want you to look at the rounded corners of the building. See it? Look at the long rectangular windows. See them? Long rectangular windows, rounded corners. Look right here. Long rectangular windows, rounded corner right here. So now we've established that the bombings of buildings in the United States are printed on our money. That's a big deal. That means that there's a force doing that. What force is doing that? Well, that's the force that the Lord God, whom I serve, allowed me to catch. The serial killer in the midst of humanity. There's a killer in the midst of humanity. It's Satan. It's Satan in you that's destroying you. You have to turn back to Christ. Let me show you with a couple magnets. I want to show you guys the simplicity. So I wrote up and down on a magnet. And same thing with this one. It says, let's see. Yep, down and up. Now, because we have a system where there's one up, one down in us. Let me fix this. Here we go. So you have up and down, you have a reversal. So watch, they won't go together. There's a force hold, there's a chasm between them. They won't go together. But watch, when you flip one, watch. Oh, and the two become whole. And your spirit gets sealed to the day of redemption, because the magnetic prison that you're in, your host body, when you make your confession to Christ, you get a spiritual rebirth, and you're no longer an up and a down. You're a double up, and your eyes have become single. Just like it said right there in Luke chapter 4, the recovery of sight to the blind, to look up. I just showed you exactly where the set of magnets. Okay, now watch this. Okay, so now right there is the federal building bombing. Here it is right here. That is identical, the same number of long rectangular windows. My fold is a little bit off right there, but there it is right there. And then over here, there's the Twin Towers, and on the back is the Pentagon. So now we have a huge problem. But now let me show you just what I believe the false flag that they may be getting the entire world ready for right now is this. So out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. So let me show you the new $100 bill real quick. There it is. So there's a new $100 bill. See it? Da, 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 da. And so when you fold it, if you look at the artwork for this, you know, here and here, you see the angles on these buildings. See that one and that one right here. When you make a five-pointed star, a pentagram out of it, and then you turn it upside down, which is what happened to the angels, we're represented by five-pointed stars. the top point, the head, arms going out, legs going down. And when you invert a five-pointed star, that becomes the church of Satan, the temple of Satan, which is what we became. The flesh is the temple of Satan because we're inverted. Do you understand? So they worship the flesh and all things carnal. Well, when we turn back to God, we get a spiritual rebirth and we're reborn of the spirit and we're sealed in Christ until the day of redemption. That's the way it works. Okay, so now watch this. When you do the exact same folding pattern as all the other bills by making a pentagram and turning it upside down, here is the image that it makes. There's the building right here, building. This is water moving in between the buildings. But you see these layers of ink right here? See the smudge? See the smudge right here? See the smudges? It almost looks like a watercolor. This is what the Lord had to show me, and there's no way I could have figured this out. So then there's another layer right there, and then there's the next layer. So one, two, three layers. And it's just like in whatever that movie was where they show the water just come blasting through the Arch of Washington. No different than looking at the Twin Towers through the Arch of Washington. I mean, it's just not even possible. So if you look at the whole row of stuff, and I'll just go like here, and we'll keep the Hoover Dam off there because the Hoover Dam's on there as well on the $50 bill. But here's there's the Pentagon, there's the Twin Towers, there's the federal building bombing, there's the backside of the federal building bombing right there. Here is the $100 bill, there's New York being nuked, and there's the tidal wave. Out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem shall cover the city by the sea. So now what I've done is I'm not just saying words. I'm saying words that the Lord put in my mouth to give to you and to show you a physical representation of those words. There it is. Is it arguable? Well, no, it's not. It's not arguable at all. It's what it is. That's why I was sent to show it many years ago after the $100 bill came out. The Lord told me you have to go show it to them, and I did not want to go. I was like, no way, I don't want to go do that. Really, you want me? No. And so I prayed and I said, if you really want me to do that, then I'm gonna open this book right there, and somehow it's gonna tell me FBI. And I literally opened up a thesaurus and it said FBI. And I was like, and so I did what the Lord said. I went and delivered it. So anyway, so now here we are. Now I'm gonna give you a way a way of looking at 9/11 from someone else's point of view. Phenomenal little video right now. It's a 5-minute video, and it shows the complete absurdity of the public narrative that was given to us. It's total nonsense. It's like the stuff I'm dealing with out of California. It's like enough already, but they can't stop. They still keep trying. There's people trying to blast through our phones, not just my phone, Corey's phone, other people's phone, trying to set up a false narrative again. It's okay, but we know what they're doing and we know why they're doing it. We know what, more than likely their little plan is. But they say that the cover-up is worse than the crime. I don't know in this case. We'll see. Anyway, so watch this. Here we go. So here we go. This is called 9/11 Conspiracy Theory Explained in 5 Minutes, the Corbett Report. Okay, phenomenal video. So here we go. Ready? And just like I said, look at it from the nonsense point of view. Like, please. They actually said on the news, and I'll never forget it, one of the hijackers' passports were found in the debris, if you can believe that. Oh, yeah. I'm sure that the hijacker had his passport, and I'm sure when it blew up the plane, allegedly blew up the twin, his passport just floated down and was right there. That's absurd. That's just stupid. It's like, it's like like I said, some of the nonsense I get to see is unbelievable. Okay, here we go. Ready? Let's do it. Thank you.
On the morning of September 11th, 2001, 19 men armed with box cutters directed by a man on dialysis in a cave fortress halfway around the world using a satellite phone and a laptop directed the most sophisticated penetration of the most heavily defended airspace in the world, overpowering the passengers and the military combat trained pilots on four commercial aircraft before flying those planes wildly off course for over an hour without being molested by a single fighter interceptor. These 19 hijackers, devout religious fundamentalists who like to drink alcohol, snort cocaine, and live with pink-haired strippers, managed to knock down three buildings with two planes in New York. While in Washington, a pilot who couldn't handle a single-engine Cessna was able to fly a 757 in an 8,000-foot descending 270-degree corkscrew turn to come exactly level with the ground, hitting the Pentagon in the budget analyst office where DoD staffers were working on the mystery of the $2.3 trillion that Defense Secretary Donald Rumsfeld had announced missing from the Pentagon's coffers in a press conference the day before, on September 10th, 2001. Luckily, the news anchors knew who did it within minutes.
Osama bin Laden.
The pundits knew within hours.
Osama bin Laden.
The administration knew within the day.
Terrorists who committed these acts and those who harbor them.
And the evidence literally fell into the FBI's lap.
That a hijacker's passport was found blocks from the World Trade Center crash site, if you can believe that.
But for some reason, a bunch of crazy conspiracy theorists demanded an investigation into the greatest attack on American soil in history. That investigation was delayed, underfunded, set up to fail, a conflict of interest, and a cover-up from start to finish. It was based on testimony extracted through torture, the records of which were destroyed. It failed to mention the existence of WTC-7, Able Danger, PTEC, Sibel Edmonds, OBL and the CIA, and the drills of hijacked aircraft being flown into buildings that were being simulated at the precise same time that those events were actually happening. It was lied to by the Pentagon, the CIA, the Bush administration, and as for Bush and Cheney, well, no one knows what they told it because they testified in secret, off the record, not under oath, and behind closed doors. It didn't bother to look at who funded the attacks because that question is ultimately of little practical significance. Still, the 9/11 Commission did brilliantly answering all of the questions the public had, except most of the victims' family members' questions, and pinned blame on all the people responsible, although no one so much as lost their job, determining the attacks were
failure of imagination.
Because
nobody in our government, at least, and I don't think the prior government that could envision flying airplanes into buildings.
Except the Pentagon, FEMA, NORAD, and the NRO. The DIA destroyed 2.5 terabytes of data on Able Danger, but that's okay because it probably wasn't important. The SEC destroyed their records on the investigation into the insider trading before the attacks, but that's okay because destroying the records of the largest investigation in SEC history is just part of routine record keeping. NIST has classified the data that they used for their model of WTC-7's collapse, but that's okay because knowing how they made their model of the collapse would jeopardize public safety. The FBI has argued that all material related to their investigation of 9/11 should be kept secret from the public, but that's okay because the FBI probably has nothing to hide. This man never existed, nor is anything he had to say worthy of your attention, and if you say otherwise, you are a paranoid conspiracy theorist and deserve to be shunned by all of humanity. Likewise him, 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 and her. And her, and her, and him. Osama bin Laden lived in a cave fortress in the hills of Afghanistan, but somehow got away. Then he was hiding out in Tora Bora, but somehow got away. Then he lived in Abbottabad for years, taunting the most comprehensive intelligence dragnet employing the most sophisticated technology in the history of the world for a decade, releasing video after video with complete impunity and getting younger and younger as he did so, before finally being found in a daring SEAL team raid which wasn't recorded on video, in which he didn't resist or use his wife as a human shield, and in which these crack special forces operatives panicked and killed this unarmed man, supposedly the best source of intelligence about those dastardly terrorists on the entire planet. Then they dumped his body in the ocean before telling anyone about it. Then a couple dozen of that team's members died in a helicopter crash in Afghanistan. This is the story of 9/11, brought to you by the media which told you the hard truths about
his hip could be seen to move violently forward.
And
they took the babies out of incubators.
And
mobile production facilities.
And
the rescue of Jessica Lynch.
If you have any questions about this story, you are a batshit, paranoid, tinfoil, dog-abusing baby hater and will be reviled by everyone. If you love your country and or freedom, happiness, rainbows, rock and roll, puppy dogs, apple pie, and your grandma, you will never ever express doubts about any part of this story to anyone. Ever. This has been a public service announcement by the friends of the FBI, CIA, NSA, DIA, SEC, MSM, White House, NIST, and the 9/11 Commission. Because ignorance is strength.
Alright, so there you go, I mean... It's the absurdity is just beyond the human brain. I mean, it's just like, okay, it's printed on your money, guys. I love you in Christ, but if you don't see it, Jesus said, They'll see, but they won't see. They'll hear, but they won't hear. And they will not understand, and they will not turn to me and let me heal them. See, we're in a twin system. You have a good and evil you. There used to be a good and evil Jonathan. And Jonathan turned to Christ with his whole heart back in 2002, and I got converted. I was a very different person before I got converted. It's fascinating to see the way it works. The Bible says you're a new creation in Christ, and I became a new creation. I became someone very different. I'm more interested in other people's well-being than my own success and, you know, I showed you the Vlad Iwer stuff. If I was worried about my own material success, I would have done Vlad Iwer. I've heard allegations made about people, from people saying, oh, John, I'm in this for the money. That's absurd. The people around me and the people that now, if you go look at the folders, and there's some more stuff that we published in the folders. If you'll simply go to the special projects too, and there's understanding relationships, this folder right here, we're just putting in more testimonies from residents right here. We're putting in testimonies, and also in the Richard Montblou folder, we're just adding just all the data points, people that lived at the Ark, their testimonies, just like a court of law. What happened when you were living there? What did you see? What was your experience? That type thing. Because when someone attacks you viciously, if someone was attacking you, making the kind of false allegations that they're making about me, well, you have to at least establish a record. I mean, it's like stupid not to. A lot of people, oh, quit talking about it. I have to keep it at bay, but I also have to establish the record. So the record's been established to a very good degree. And so that's just the way it works. And if it was you, I'm sure you would understand, or you would at least approach it the same way. At least hopefully you would. Okay, so now we have a record established that the bombings are on the money, yes or no? So let's just talk about that. Yes or no, are the bombings on your money? It's a yes or no answer. Is the Twin Tower bombing printed on your $20 bill, yes or no? So if the answer is yes, then there's a huge problem. A huge problem. Now there's a One World Freedom Tower. One World Freedom, doest thou wilt. That's the meaning behind it. One World Freedom. We remember, we rebuild, we come back stronger. Who's we? Written on that 11,000 pound beam. Remember, 11 in the Bible is place of destruction, I believe. Like planet K. Yeah, the number 11 is place of destruction. So none of it adds up anymore at all. So I wanted to bring these things up because right now with Israel, just stop and think, well, wait a minute. I understand that attacks took place yesterday, and it's probably more significant that it was more of a setup than actual a reality. Does that make sense to you? What I'm saying is, it's like it was allowed to happen. If you have the Israeli airspace and you're telling me a bunch of guys just on paragliders on different cities, everybody just, we're going to fly in and wreak havoc. And you're telling me that the Israeli defense did not have a heads up, and none of their intelligence agencies or none of the world intelligence agencies. And then you got Biden saying he supports Israel. That's pure nonsense. That's not real. That's fake. Biden doesn't support Israel. We know that because he gave them the $6 billion and left all that equipment over there that could be used against Israel. I think $87 billion in Afghanistan. That'll all be used by the Islamic group to go against Israel, because in a spiritual sense, Israel is this little teeny sliver of on the map, and they're surrounded by countries that hate them and want to kill them and wipe them off the map. They've said it. Well, it's like us, those of us that are Christians, we are surrounded by people that hate us and want to destroy us. That's a fact. That's just the way it is. It's reality. Now, I'm going to show you the twin female system. Let's go to the twin system. It's very important that you guys understand that there is a twin system, and that's what rules over the system. Let me get a couple of videos I have. I want to show you, first of all, let's start with just the physical manifestation of that, the twin female system. It's right in front of you all the time. They put it out right in front of you to mock the sheep that are in the system. Now, don't forget, the sheep are angels and we're spiritual beings, but we're trapped in bodies. And our master is from heaven, El, the Almighty God. So when El, the Almighty God, comes into the system to rescue his angels, he comes in as Immanuel, with us is El, the Almighty God. Elohim is the opponent to El, the Almighty God. So watch this. Okay, pause this. Okay, so one thing I'd like to do real quick is just show you a David Bowie clip. It's about 2 minutes, and David Bowie is releasing his video game called Omicron. Isn't that fascinating? That's one of the variants of, you know, the serpent sheep slaughter thing. What's interesting is when you go into the video game, it all turns upside down and it's a female. What have I been telling you? The whole female thing, the whole female energy was the trap for God's angels. And here's that phenomenal thing the Lord gave me the other day. When he told me, pick up that CD, and it's that, I was like, you couldn't even think this up. You couldn't even think up that the Lord had me walk. He told me, go into the Half-Price bookstore. That's what he told me. I want to show you something. Because this would suggest that we're right at the door, because my parachute is V for vengeance. It's right side up, upside down triangle, and it represents the female energy within the system, us. So if you haven't been cleansed of your sins, if you haven't been born again, if you haven't had a, so female energy is down, male energy is up. If you haven't had a spiritual rebirth back to your father, then when whatever happens, happens, or when you die, then your energy has to go according to that magnetic field that you're trapped in. So boom, you go to the pit. But if you've been sealed into the day of redemption, when your host body dies, you go back to the Father, because he bought you with his work on the cross. So you accept Christ as your personal savior, and then the superhuman angel demon is no longer a superhuman angel demon. It becomes Christ, Holy Spirit. Ephesians 2, just read it, 2:2. Twin towers. I mean, is this getting really obvious? Okay, well, let's watch Omicron. Let's just watch it. And then look at what David Bowie's outward manifestation of his video game is. And when you go into the system, you get turned upside down. There's a stripper, a female pole dance. And then as you go through the next 2 minutes, he's narrating, saying, you're not the first player to get trapped in Omicron. Get your soul trapped. And then I think he says, and the only way to get out is to find the serial killer, but no one knows where he lives. I can tell you exactly where he lives. Ready? He lives inside of you. He lived inside of me. He had a place in my heart until I turned back to the Lord God with my whole heart. Not part of it. Lord, that's it. I'm done. I can't do it anymore. Nothing makes sense. I give up. I want to accept Jesus. I just don't know which one he is. I just want to know the truth. Bam, 100% nylon, 100% no line. Okay, Johnny, now you work for me. Okay, so ready? Let's listen to this. Here we go. I'll try and turn it up all the way. Here we go. Please pay attention. Look right here. See the word up? So the way to solve the entire thing, they left up on the screen the whole time. Jesus said he's come to restore the sight to the blind. Because if you come into the system and you get inverted, well, the way to know the truth, Jesus said you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. So the way to know the truth is to invert everything and see the truth. You're seeing Jesus then. You're understanding the system then. It's two halves of an equation. But until you resolve it, you can't see the other half. You understand? Here we go. Watch. Why did they leave up here the whole time?
the stranger in Omicron, conqueror of demons. A long time ago, I was a human being like you. A demon surprised me in my apartment. He killed both my wife and me.
Take us to the edge of time. Take us to the edge of time. We are the fabulous double.
You're not the first video game player to get your soul trapped in this dimension.
Omicron, you can feel us coming.
The survival of your soul is at stake. The only way to save your soul is to kill Astaroth. But nobody knows where he hides. The only way to save your soul is to kill Astaroth. But nobody knows where he hides.
Okay, so the only way to save your soul is to kill Astaroth, but no one knows where he hides. He hides inside of you. But you have to look up, just like it says in Luke chapter 4, to restore your sight. Why do you think the image of the virgin, the female, is a dead sheep when you turn it up? So do you see the perfection in what the Lord's let me show you? Isn't it fascinating that, you know, there's this concerted effort to try and tie me to something that I'm not involved in at all, but there's too many people trying way too hard, and man, they just, the cover-up's worse than the crime. And it's just, it's fascinating to me just to watch and just to see how, wow, a lot of people are really, really willing to go to some crazy measures. Anyway, so up right here. Up. How do you solve it? Turn everything up. Okay, that is made manifest over and over again because the imagery that the Lord's let me put together for you, the God whom I serve, look, here it is, ready? There is the dead sheep. See the dead sheep right there? Eye, eye, nostril, nostril, tongue sticking out. Why is the virgin a dead sheep? Well, it's the same as Omicron. I mean, you got to find the serial killer. You got to kill him inside of you. And the only way to kill him inside of you is turn back to Christ. And don't give him a place in your heart. You understand? It's the most obvious thing in the world. Look, I mean, can anyone argue with that? Is that a sheep with its tongue sticking out and not the virgin? Of course it is. Why do you think the Vatican is built in the shape of an upside down cross at the bottom of this yellow keyhole, and then the whole thing turns to a serpent. The whole upside down cross turns to a serpent wearing a crown. I mean, and it's birthing another serpent. So there, this is not arguable. People can sit there and call me what they want all day long. Doesn't mean a thing. Those are words. I'm coming with power. I'm showing up with data. I'm showing up with supernatural data. Again, the Lord lets me lay hands on people that are terminally ill and they get well. People that are blind, legally blind, and they have their sight. I think it's 2030 now. You know, there's a testimony with me. But the very people that make the allegations against me don't do any of the works. So it's easy to see who's who. Especially for the Lord God. I mean, the Lord God sees everything. God is not mocked. You reap what you sow. So, and here is the system. I mean, the system is just so obvious. It's just phenomenal. Here is a guy hugging a girl at downtown Grand Junction. It makes an X on his back. And that's the system. And then if you just look at the other side, all you have to do is go around the statue and it's a serpent strangling out a sheep. So the female energy is strangling out the sheep, the guy, the male energy. Female energy strangles out the male within the system. That's the Ouroboros. So it's absolutely solved. There's no doubt about it. But I got to experience, a real life understanding. That's me and my girlfriend. Now, does that before we got married, does that look just like this? Yes or no? Does this statue look just like this? Well, sure. This looks like two people that are just hugging each other like they're in love. Yes. But then the statue turns into a serpent killing a sheep. And here's the card that the very person I'm hugging gave me. Look at that. I see the serpent right away. There's the eye of the serpent. There's the nose of the serpent. There's the open mouth of the serpent. This is also the skin on the stretched mouth of the serpent. And then if you turn your head to the left, you'll see the sheep. There's the eye of the sheep. Here's the ear of the sheep, top of the head. There's the eye coming down the nose. There's the mouth. There's the line in the mouth. There's the bottom jaw. Here's the neck. So this whole white thing becomes a sheep. So isn't it fascinating that the very person that I'm hugging, just like that statue, handed me a card that's a serpent eating a sheep? Do you understand? Now, does she know she's doing that? No, but what's running her does, because she wasn't surrendered to Christ. So here it is. Here's an actual serpent eating an egg. See the serpent eating the egg? Here's the serpent off the card eating the sheep. Now I just turned it upside down. There's a sheep. There's the eye. There's a teardrop. Nose, line in the mouth. I mean, so see, again, I'm not just coming with words. I'm coming with major power, major, supernatural. The Vatican's a snake, yes or no? So is the Vatican a snake? Well, it is obviously a snake. Is it an upside down cross? Well, obviously, I just showed it to you colored red, and I showed it to you at the bottom of a keyhole, representing the door being locked. So let's go back and look at the Vatican being this upside down cross so you understand the significance of that, because I told you I was going to give you data, right? So let's do some data. Let me pause it so you don't have to watch me scroll. Hang on one sec. So again, here is St. Peter's Basilica and Square. Here it is. And so here is the keyhole. So I colored it yellow for you. So this is a keyhole. And that's an obelisk in the middle. And that's an eight-pointed star made by those lines. And that represents the penis of Osiris. You'll see them all around the world. Why is it in the middle of an eight-pointed star? Is that an upside-down cross at the bottom of a keyhole? It's a yes or no. There's a red upside-down cross. So if you look at the Vatican from Google Earth, the Vatican building itself becomes an upside-down cross. Well, wasn't Peter crucified upside down? He was. Jesus told him his death would glorify God. Because Jesus was crucified right side up. Peter was crucified upside down, representing the system that you're trapped in. But the way to get out of the system is Jesus told Peter, I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Ready? You put the key in the lock. You turn the key upside down and the door opens. Oh, it's the most simple thing in the world. It's called being on the rock. Why do you think the Lord took me to Chinati and in a riverbed of trillions of rocks, said, pick up those two rocks? And I picked up two black rocks and he said, now put them together. And I was like, put them together. And they were two halves of the same rock, because I'm the guy that the Lord God chose to show the world what being on the rock was. Two halves of the same rock, invert one, put them back together. And that accomplishes your salvation, because upon this rock, I will found my church. Jesus is the rock of ages, because this is the understanding of the entire system. You will know the truth. And the truth will set you free. Jesus is the truth. But in the system, the truth was inverted. We got inverted. So there's truth and lies in the system. So now it's not double truth. You have one truth and you got a lie, one eye that's good, one eye that's bad. That's why if your eye be single, your whole body is full of light. Because light is up, dark is down. So if you get the other eye inverted, then you look up. And your eyes become single. You become redoubled. Okay, so let me show you that in the scriptures, because the scriptures are everything. So now we'll go to Isaiah 61, which is what the book of Isaiah is, what Jesus read out of when he took his ministry right here. Isaiah 61, here we go. So watch this. So Jesus read The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty, freedom, pure. It says freedom and pure. Look, so freedom and pure. Okay. Liberty to the captives, those that were transported into captivity, carried away captive. I mean, to me, it's mind-boggling that Richard Montblou was carried away captive, and then he escaped. And now he's at a point of restoration where he's safe. That's just mind-boggling to me. So, to proclaim liberty to the captives, ready the opening of the prison. So this has got to be huge. So this is in Isaiah, and this is what Jesus read to take his public ministry, and this is where it shows you everything. Yes or no, does it say redoubled opening of a dungeon right there? Redoubled opening of a dungeon, salvation from sin. So it's a yes or no answer. And I don't know any other way to give this to you with any more precision than this. This is the Word of God coupled with a supernatural gift to show you the virgin is a dead sheep, the Vatican's a snake, the mouth of the snake is eating a bunch of angels, the angels are what the serpent race eats within the host body system. It's the most obvious thing in the world, and the Lord has let me show it to you now. I don't know any other way to show it to you any more precisely. Now watch. The opening of the prison, does it say redoubled opening of a dungeon? Redoubled. So that's what opens the dungeon, yes or no? So I'm going to highlight that a very bright yellow. Watch this. There it is. Very bright yellow. Redoubled. That's a semicolon right there. See the semicolon? Redoubled, semicolon. So the redoubled and the semicolon tells you what the redoubled means. Opening of a dungeon. Okay, and the root of the word right here means to open the senses, especially the eyes. So yes or no? Jesus's ministry was to redouble your eyes, yes or no? To redouble your eyes, yes or no? Why do you think the Bible says if your eye offends you? You know what the word offend means? Turn upside down. If your eye offends you, pluck it out. It's better to enter the kingdom of heaven with one eye than to be cast into hell where the worm never dies, because there's a worm attached to that eye, and the fire is never quenched. Because down in the pit, the worm that's feeding off you your whole life, Satan's the king of the worms. It's a locust. It's a cankerworm, a locust. That's why in movies like Prometheus, if you've ever seen it, there's a worm in the guy's eye. Yes, this is serious stuff, you guys. You think Satan's pissed that I just lifted up the rock and exposed his little scorpion kingdom? You think he's mad at me? What do you think he might do to try and set Jonathan Kleck up using anyone that's not honest and truthful? Probably go to some severe links. But the Lord laughs at those. The Lord laughs at them. And they just won't stop. Anyway, the opening of prison to them that are bound. Let's look at the word bound. To yoke or to hitch, to join in battle. Now, do y'all remember the tattoo on the guy's back of the angel? Let me see if that's readily available. If it is, I'll show it to you again just to make a point. I'll go over here. Hang on. So let me ask you this. This is a Van Halen album. It says balance. So there's no longer a kid at the top of the seesaw. See, he's no longer at the top. He represents the angel that slid down and is attached to the demon. Now look. The angel that was up top slid down and now he's attached to the demon. 23 and 23. We put those jerseys on him because YouTube said that was showing child stuff, and I'm like, okay, that's a Van Halen album, whatever. So is the Van Halen album right here, is it identical to the tattoo on the guy's back? Yes or no? There's the demon, there's the angel. They're bound together right here by this chain in the middle. This also makes a penis and a scrotum when the devil is looking up from the pit, because this is the system that the devil owns. That's why the Vatican is a serpent and the building next to it is a snake. It's parthenogenesis, twin female energy, starting a host body system. That's what it is. Satan's called the accuser of the brethren. All they do is accuse all the time. And if you go look at your folders, there's some comments in there that were put on some of these just demonic channels where people are making accusations that people that, you know, posted emails from their own husbands giving them an email. So one of our subscribers, their husband gave them emails, and there's people that are with the Sullivans and the Edges that are making accusations that the person that gave us that stuff, that she hacked her own husband. That's crazy, because I heard that same nonsense, like I'm hacking someone's computers. No, that may be someone trying to set up it to make it look like that because they're involved. But no, I wouldn't be able to hack a ham sandwich. So whatever. But there's people that would try and do that, I believe. Mm-hmm. So anyway, so how fascinating, yes or no? Is that an angel that is tied, yoked to a demon, yes or no? Okay, let's go back to the Bible. And the opening of the prison, there it is, to redouble, to save from jail or delivery, figuratively salvation from sin. It says, I'm sorry, jail delivery, figuratively salvation from sin, and redoubling to open the senses, especially the eyes, to them that are bound. I'm sorry, guys. On some of this, I have to look over the edge of my computer to try and read on its screen that's actually behind my actual screen, because I have a bigger screen because my eyes, I have to enlarge everything. I can't. So I have to look over like this to try and read. So sometimes my reading's not the best. Okay, so anyway, so to yoke or to hitch, to fasten in any sense, to join in battle. Okay, so here we go. Are they fastened together, joined in battle, a demon with an angel, and this is Satan ruling over that system? Isn't it fascinating that the entire image makes a sheep? So I'm going to show you the image with no drawing. Here's the eye of the sheep coming down. Here's the nose, nostril, line in the lip. I can see the sheep. Here's his ear. Oh, there you go, right there. There's the sheep. I colored it in white for you. Here's the head of the sheep, the eye, the ear, the face, the nostril, the line in the lip. That's a sheep, guys. The whole system, the whole thing becomes also a human heart. This is all a human heart. And you see the dividing line right down the middle of the heart? Cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. So that tattoo is a manifestation of the Bible right there. Wow. Just to be able to see that is miraculous. Okay, so now we're at a point right now, at this very moment in time, that Israel is being attacked. I know they're shooting off rockets and stuff, but the initiation of it looks like it's contrived. During the bombing of the Twin Towers, they were running a drill of someone bombing buildings in New York. And they just happened to have the air defense system turned off at that time. Does that seem plausible to you? Or does that seem like a total setup? Well, if Satan is running the show on the whole place, I mean, it's stupid obvious now, isn't it? It's just stupid obvious. And what I see people doing out in the world and the news stuff going on, it's just stupid obvious. This is the sea of humanity turning terrible before your very eyes right now. You're watching it. That's part of the prophetic utterance the Lord gave me. And the sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes, and the terrible one shall be elevated within the sea. And behold, the man of peace, Barack Hussein Obama, shall come forth from the sea, and with words of peace he will bring chaos and destruction. I mean, I have to be faithful to the Lord God whom I serve. It may not be very pleasant sometimes to have to deal with the reality of putting that out in the general public and being persecuted for it, but I'm a true believer. I know that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I don't think so. I know so, and he lives inside of me, so I will serve the King, El, the Almighty God, the King of the universe. Now, here's an interesting thing. You know, the Bible says, the earth is my throne. I mean, I'm sorry. Heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Okay, so El, the Almighty God, is male energy. Now, stop and think about this. Just pay attention. So, El, the Almighty God, heaven is my throne, heaven, and the earth is my footstool, where he walks around. I'm going to show this to you in the scriptures. Well, in Proverbs 5, it says, her ways are immovable. Thou canst not know them. And her feet take hold on hell. And the word for feet is pedina, which is vagina. So let me show you that the twin female system that runs the show here is owned by Satan. And I'm just going to show you like a commercial or two, show you some pictures out of the folders. You guys need to go through all the folders. They are just beyond the human brain. More valuable than all the money in the world. I'm telling you, more valuable. If I could choose the folders over $1 billion, I would take the folders. No doubt about it. Okay. And I may get that opportunity here real soon. Uh-huh. Yep. Uh-huh. So now let me show you an Ian Bud Light commercial. Ready? Now imagine what you're looking at is not a commercial to sell you Budweiser beer. It's a commercial to show you the system that you're trapped in. The name Kelly means a female warrior. That's what the name Kelly means. Look it up yourself. The name Ian means gift from God. What's God's gift? The gift of life within the system. The whole thing. He owns the entire thing. Without him, none of us exist. In him and through him, we exist. And he's willing to die on a cross even so everyone could have an existence. It's so far beyond the human reign. It's mind-boggling. Okay, but watch this commercial closely. Please pay attention to it and look at the spiritual aspect of the whole commercial. It's unbelievable. Ready? Here we go.
Seconds ago, we gave Ian Rappaport a Bud Light and a choice. Ian is not an actor. He has no idea what's going to happen next.
I think I could do that.
All right, he's in a limo, Reggie. That's you.
How are you? What's your name?
Ian Rappaport.
Ian Rappaport. Ian.
But I'll mess it up.
Hey.
Hey.
Ian.
Very nice to meet
Minka,
you.
Nice
Minka,
to meet you.
Definitely know who you are.
We need a coat for you.
Okay. It's pretty awesome being styled by Minka Kelly tonight.
I wish I could come with you.
I know. I wish you could too.
Bye, guys.
Minka, that was awesome.
Joe.
Good evening.
Hello, Lily.
Hey!
There.
Come on, Lily. Lily.
Hey, Don.
Now, I'm gonna pause it for a minute because the word Lily means pure. Llamas were used as sacrifices in the Incan creation myth. And all of a sudden, a llama comes in and he's with a black guy, Don Cheadle, that's dressed identically to Ian. How can you not see what this is? This is Ian going to his own sacrifice. Now he's got his own doppelganger. And here we go. Watch. It gets even more crazy. Here.
How are you?
Hey, how's it going?
Nice to see you.
Are we ready to go?
Nice, Jeff.
Stand by.
Open the door.
Door, 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 door.
Yes.
Why did two twin females get in the elevator with Ian? Why does Ian have his own black twin? I mean, you know, this is just stupid obvious now, right? Is this a Bud Light commercial, or is it a Bud Light commercial mocking all the sheep in the system that they're murdering because there's a serial killer in the system? It's so obvious, it's just stupid at this point. Okay, ready? Here we go. Now watch when he goes into the party with all the twins. It turns red because Ian's the rack of rice.
This is a bizarre night. Take care, Ian.
Take care, Ian. Evil. Evil. It's evil. This is an evil commercial. Look at it.
Everyone here is a twin? My mind is blown.
They're on their way down.
They appear to be crushed in tiny tennis.
Okay, let's see the arms. You all look all pumped up. Very good. Just give me 5 push-ups.
I'm going to go back. I want you to look at the rows. See? 6, 6, 6. White and blue, white and blue, white and blue. There's 3 rows of 6, 6, 6. Some of them are like Arnold Schwarzenegger wearing the white shirt, doing the Nut, the Egyptian goddess Nut, the system that we're trapped in, the female system, making the arch over us, trapping us. 666, and there's Ian. Look, there's Ian's face, and then there's Arnold Schwarzenegger doing Nut. Yes or no? Or am I a false prophet and a Satanist, like some people just can't stop screaming because they have their reason?
I knew it. Bring it up. But they're beautiful girls, huh? Don't be shy when it comes to counting for me. You can do better than that. Come on. Ready, my little man here. It's not a bad shot for my little princess.
Perfect beer for when you somehow find yourself in a limo with Reggie Watts and some bachelorettes, then get styled by Minka Kelly before Don Cheadle, a llama named Lily, and the identical twin of the girl you just met take you to a party where you defeat Arnold Schwarzenegger in a sudden death ping pong match that puts you on stage with One Republic. Bud Light.
Okay, so they're playing the song We'll Be Counting Stars. What's Lucifer's goal? Let's go to Isaiah. Let's go to Isaiah. So see, everything I'm showing you is right out of the Bible. That's Isaiah 14. They're saying, we'll be counting stars. For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars, the princes of El, the Almighty God. And see, El is the Almighty God. So they're hunting God's angels in the system. That's all there is to it. We'll be counting stars because we got you in a twin female system. That's it. There's not even arguable. So, okay, now I'm going to let this video stand alone. It's 1 hour and 9 minutes, a little. Guys, now's the time to make your confession to Christ. Just admit you're a sinner. You deserve to go to the pit. We sinned against the Most High. We took the forbidden fruit. We're in it. And now he wants to forgive you and just accept you back. All you got to do is, with your whole heart, confess your sins to him. That's it. That's all you got to do. Say you're sorry and you mean it. Not lip service, but you'll be put to a test probably. I know I was. The Lord showed me right out of the gate. Either you're going to tell the truth or you're not. And I did. And it could have been a very bad situation. And I told the truth. So he'll probably put you in a situation like that. Now, if you're a person and you're trapped in a situation where you've done some really bad shit and you know you have and you need to just confess it. It's okay. You'll be all right. Just tell the truth. Don't keep lying. Just stop and tell the truth and say, I'll accept my consequences. God is merciful. He's merciful. So anyway, but if you hold the course and you hold to your lies, then there's nothing he can do for you. And that's it. And you will have to answer to El, the Almighty God. When what may be happening in the next, very quickly, it looks like the false flag for World War III has been set up with the Israel thing. I'm just going to say it. That's what it looks like to me. Especially with what's going on in my life being the harbinger. It's crazy. It's like nonstop throwing these fake arrows, trying to set up false narratives over and over and over again, trying to break through on phones, making this nonsense keep going. It's like they can't stop. Anyway. All right. Peace and grace, guys. I love you in Christ. God bless you. Thank you for letting me minister to you. Thank you for letting me just come into your houses and your world and just trying to help you. I'm sorry that sometimes when I'm out here late at night and I get fired up and I just want to say, this is what's going on. Are you listening to me? You know, because there's a lot of, I mean, imagine the stuff that I deal with. It's crazy. It's like the things that I deal with are crazy. But go look in all the folders. We're putting comments that are people are making over at the Gene Rebel channel that are completely contradictory to other people, you know, like trying to say someone that posted something from their husband's email was hacking her own husband. That's sick. That's twisted. That's wicked. Anyway, but time will tell. Everything will come out in the wash, they say. And I think the big wash is about to happen. The king's coming. Jesus is coming. I was called as a harbinger to announce the arrival of a king. And the King of Kings is coming. Praise God. All right. Let's do a hug, huh? Let's do this. Let's do the bear. And that's you. And I love you in Christ. And I hope you're well. And I hope you're safe. Don't be afraid of anything. Just stand up for the truth. For the truth. Love you in Christ. The King's coming. And I think he's coming really, really quick. Anyway, stay the course. All right. God bless you.